¡Hey, amigos! ¿Qué onda para Fit Rock? Acá Julio Beltrán. Y miren, nada más estoy extasiado aquí con la presencia de este señor campeón. Me siento bien contento, honrado y afortunado. Pero qué mejor manera que él solito se presente, porque trae muchísimas ganas de contar su experiencia, sus cosas, sus viajes, en fin.
What's up, Mexico? This is Ulysses. My first time here. It's been a while. Actually, I've been looking to visit Mexico. And I'm just glad to be here. And I'm glad... to really just come and check out the whole experience. So thank you guys for having me. It's been amazing so far.
How many trips at social media? We always looking at you, that you are here, there, Dubai, India, LA, Miami. How many trips of work do you make a year?
That's really, really tough, because some years I do a lot more and some years is a lot less. But I do travel. I'll say I travel more than 10 times a year. So it's probably more, actually double that, I would say. But the good thing is, with social media and the fan base, you know, it's good to really network and connect with the fans, and going to different regions, going to different countries, and being able to talk to them, meet them, greet, train, work out. I think a lot of them appreciate that, and it means a lot, you know, because they see you on magazines and see you on social media all the time. So it's always good. That's why I love doing expos, fitness shows, and just traveling and experiencing it with the fans. So I'm grateful for that, and I'm just happy for the support that I've gotten so far.
How do you feel that it's life being a superstar, celebrity fitness? How is it?
I don't really consider myself a celebrity fitness superstar. I just look at myself as just more of a motivator that motivate people, because when I started fitness and bodybuilding, there was no one there. We only had books to read of Arnold and those guys, really. Yeah. Social media wasn't what it is now. So for me, I look at myself more as a motivator, to motivate kids to train, be healthy, take care of their physique, work out and learn, because there's such a huge epidemic about unhealthy eating and obesity and all that kind of stuff. So if we start the kids off at a young age where they realize sports, nutrition, being healthy is key, then I think it's going to help the world in general. So I'm not a superstar. I'm just more of a motivator.
Do you know that Mexico is a number one of obesity of all over the world in kids and grown-ups?
Yes, I was told about that, actually, which I was really surprised. I wouldn't think Mexico would even be in the top five, you know. I think that's why health and fitness and training, nutrition in general, is very, very important. So the more we spread the word, the better it is, especially for the young generation, that when you hit 13, 14, and you know, you're looking for something to do, you want, you know, back then we didn't have all of that. So now it's more like, oh, social media, oh, what, fitness is a strong part of social media. Oh, I want to train, I want to get better, I want to improve myself. I think that really helps them. Kids start watching what they eat, you know, they're very conscious of that, you know, improve their eating. And I think if we can do that, it would help Mexico in general, because, yeah, that's mind boggling. I would have never thought Mexico would be even in the top three in terms of obesity.
So, yeah, we are number one. And have you tried the food of here in Mexico?
I hear the food is a big part of it. Yeah. I have tried the food, and actually it's very, very good. But the thing is, with me, when we talk about food and what's healthy and what's not, it's all about moderation, right? You don't want to eat too much of something that you know it's detrimental to your health or anything like that. So I think it's just being smart, healthy, preparing the food more healthy, being more health conscious. If you do that, then it's fine. I mean, I have an African background, and African food also is not the best to have every single day. Heavy rice, heavy sauce, it's not really the best. But if you are able to prepare it better, and you have to, and you're able to have it in moderation, then it becomes better. You know, I do that all the time. I don't visit my family every day, because I don't think I would have a great shape if I did. But when I do see them, I have a meal, and it's moderate. And I always tell people, you don't eat to be full, and you know, I eat more as to feed me as a machine, you know. So I don't eat, and like I'm not stuffed when I eat. So I eat sensible. I have moderate portions. I look at the meal. I'm sensible with what I eat. So I think once you become aware of that, then your mindset is different as to the general public, where people just want to eat. You know, you have a big rack of ribs and you have to finish it. You know, you cannot sustain that on an everyday basis. So it's just about being sensible with your diet. I think that's the key.
You know, there's a lot of people that say that things that, especially you, for your skin color, your ethnics, it's easier to get shredded, your body mass, whatever. What do you think about that?
People say that even with aesthetics, like your shape and this. I disagree with that, really, because I have a lot of friends from different ethnicity, white, Mexican, Spanish, that have amazing physiques, like really, really good physique. I think it's more of an individual kind of thing. One of the analogy I like to always give is the fact that you can have the best genetics and best everything, but if your work ethic is not there, if you don't eat right, if you don't train and you don't have the discipline, you would never know that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I was a very slim kid, very skinny, very small. If I never worked out and if I never was disciplined, then I would not see what I have today.
Sure.
You see what I mean? So I think it's more of an individual thing in terms of discipline, in terms of diet, in terms of work ethic. If you implement those things, then yes, I mean, if you have a great genetics or good genetics, then it shows. It even looks better. But if you don't implement the hard work and the dedication and the commitment, you will never know. So I think commitment and hard work comes first. I think having, you know, your background, maybe that's icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Once you've done all the hard work, I think so. But hard work comes first, I think.